As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah once again. Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala. So we're now at Juz 24, alhamdulillah. And this is a juz that has, subhanAllah, some beautiful connections between all three surahs that we're going to cover today. Surah Az-Zumar, Surah Ghafir, and Fussilat. So these three surahs actually bring together a very beautiful, beautiful, beautiful theme, inshallah ta'ala. I'm sure that you all, hopefully, bidnillahi ta'ala, will enjoy it and hopefully find some major benefit in it. SubhanAllah, it's very powerful how these three things are connected, how these three surahs are connected. First of all, just if you look at the top of this page, actually, what's pinned to the top of this page, it's actually a reflection on قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. It's a reflection on the verse in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, say, O my servants who have transgressed against themselves, do not despair from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives all sins. And indeed, it is He who is forgiving and the ever forgiving and ever merciful. This is a section from Surah Az-Zumar. And this is, in particular, this ayah is what the ulama called the most hopeful ayah in the Qur'an. It's an ayah that gives us all hope, that gives us all a sense of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how our entrance into Jannah is not because of us, but it's because of who Allah is. So it's not because of who we are, it's because of who Allah is. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ever merciful and ever forgiving. Now, this section of ayat, so this is actually the beginning of Juz 24. This section of ayat, it starts at verse 53. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, don't despair from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because Allah forgives all sins. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَنِيبُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ وَأَسْلِمُوا لَهُ. And turn back to your Lord and submit yourself to Him. مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَكُمُ الْعَذَابُ ثُمَّ لَا تُمْصَرُونَ. Before the punishment comes to you, and then you will not be helped. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us to turn course, focus yourself on actually turning back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, on actually coming back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let it show in your actions that you desire the mercy of God, that you actually want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you no matter what. And at the same time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, before the punishment comes to you, and then you will not be helped. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alludes to one of the reasons why people stay away from Him, or one of the things that keeps a person sinning. And that is that a person looks around them and they see other people sinning, or they depend upon other people. And subhanAllah, usually in this world, when you get in trouble, then, if you have a connection, then you can usually get yourself out of trouble, right? Depending on how grievous the connection is or the penalty is. But, you know, if you have the right connection, you can get yourself out of trouble. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that on that day, you're not going to find anyone to help you. So you need to turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Stop depending upon your allies or your circle or whatever it may be. Focus instead on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاتَّبِعُوا أَحْسَنَ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ. And follow the best of what was revealed to you from your Lord. مِنْ قَبْلِ أَن يَأْتِيَكُمُ الْعَذَابُ بَغْتَةً وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ. Before the punishment comes to you suddenly, and you don't, while you perceive not, while you're not even paying attention. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses here the disease of procrastination. So again, the two diseases that are addressed here, the two things that keep us from turning back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, either the company that we keep or our procrastination. There's this idea that, you know, we'll turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala one day and everything will be okay. Okay? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us these, he warns us from falling into these traps and not turning back to Him. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes us to the day of judgment, what people are saying. He says, أَنْتَقُولَ نَفْسٌ يَا حَسْرَةَ عَلَى مَا فَرَّتُ فِي جَنْبِ اللَّهِ وَإِنْ كُنْتُ لَمِنَ السَّاخِرِينَ. So that lest a person should say, يَا حَسْرَةَ عَلَى مَا فَرَّتُ فِي جَنْبِ اللَّهِ. In Surah Yasin, يَا حَسْرَةَ عَلَى الْعِبَادِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, what regret for mankind, what a shame for mankind. Here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, a person is saying, Ya hasrata, oh how great is my regret over what I neglected in regard to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ala ma farrattu fi jambillah. Because I did not do what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered me to do. And then what does he say? Wa in kuntu lamina sakhirin. And I used to be amongst those that used to mock the truth. Now, check out this connection. This is verse 56, right? Verse 54, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, turn back to Allah, because no one's going to help you on the day of judgment. Because a lot of times we're deceived by the people around us and we lower our standards because we say the people around us, well, look at all these sins, right? Look at what they're doing. And our company is not the best company. Verse 56, the consequence, a person says, وَإِن كُنْتُ لَمِنَ السَّاخِرِينَ, I was amongst the wrong group of people. So a person acknowledges that they belong to the wrong group of people, and that group of people, that company that they kept them away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَوْ تَقُولَ لَوْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ هَدَانِي لَكُنْتُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Or that person says, if only Allah had guided me, then I certainly would have been amongst the pious. So the person refuses to accept their own responsibility, and they say, if only Allah had guided me, then I would have been amongst the pious. This is a person who deflects responsibility. This is verse 57. In verse 54, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is warning, once again, you will not have anyone to help you on the day of judgment. And a person who constantly looks around at the people around them and follows their standards and doesn't set standards for themselves, a person who lives their life like sheep, you know, is not going to understand the sense of personal accountability and, you know, trying to repent and turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the sake of their own good. So first they look around and they see the people that led them astray and they say, I was with the wrong group of people. And then they have the nerve to say, if Allah would have guided me, then I would have been pious. It's like when you see someone that's really distant from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, at least as it appears to people, at least with their actions. You invite them to leave the sins that they're committing, and they say, make dua for me, right? Make dua for me, which is good. Make dua. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you hidayah. But if you mean by make dua for me that you know, that you're escaping your own sense of accountability, that Allah has not already given you enough incentive to leave that sin, then there's a problem in the dua that you're requesting. Okay? So take a personal responsibility like Adam alayhi salam. Do not deflect to the point that you will even blame your Lord the way that Shaytan did. So a person would say, لَوْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ هَدَانِي لَكُنْتُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. If Allah would have guided me, I would have been from the righteous, I would have been from the pious. أَوْ تَقُولَ حِينَ تَرَى الْعَذَابَ لَوْ أَنَّ لِي كَرَّ فَأَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Or that person would say, when they see the punishment, once the punishment finally shows itself to them, reveals itself to them, that person would say, if only I had another chance to return to the world, then I would have been from the muhsineen. I would have been from the people of excellence. I would have been from the people who worship Allah as if they could see Him. I would have been from those who excel all standards, right? SubhanAllah, this is verse 58. In verse 55, what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warn us from? Allah warned us from procrastination. مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَكُمُ الْعَذَابُ بَغْتَةً وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ. From procrastinating until we were struck by the punishment while we're not even perceiving, while we are not even awake or privy to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised us will come. So Allah warns, you know, that don't wait to see the punishment to say, if I had another chance, right? Don't procrastinate because you don't know when your time will come. And instead, worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if you can see Him, even though you have not seen Him yet. And fear hellfire as if you can see it, even though you have not seen it yet. And hope for paradise as if you can see it, even though you have not seen it yet, because you know that it's real. You know that it's true. So don't wait for death to come to you, or don't procrastinate until suddenly your life is taken away from you and you're standing and you're looking at this entire thing play out in front of you and you're saying, you know, if only I had another chance, then not only would I be a Muslim, not only would I be a muttaqi, a believer, a righteous person, whatever it may be, I would be from the muhsineen. I'd be from those who excel all standards, working for the sight of God and trying to do things that will benefit me in the hereafter, because I know that it's coming. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, بَلَا قَدْ جَاءَتْكَ آيَاتِي فَكَذَّبْتَ بِهَا وَاسْتَكْبَرْتَ وَكُنْتَ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ. Rather, my evidences came to you and you denied them, and you were amongst the proud and you were amongst those who rejected. وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ تَرَى الَّذِينَ كَذَبُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ وُجُوهُهُمْ مُسْوَدَّةٌ أَلَيْسَ فِي جَهَنَّمَ مَثْوًى لِلْمُتَكَبِّرِينَ. And you would see on the day of resurrection, those who lied against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, their faces would be darkened. Is there not in hell an abode for the arrogant and for those who are prideful? Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we continue with this surah, Surah Az-Zumar sort of gives us that hope, that seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, seek the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because He forgives all things. But at the same time, do not belittle Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or seek to belittle Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or His commands, and escape your own responsibility to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because you will still be held accountable. So Allah wants to see effort on your part. You have to show effort. You're not going to get into Jannah by your good deeds, but you are going to show effort that you tried to qualify for the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by virtue of these small good deeds that we do. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَيُنَجِّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا بِمَفَازَتِهِمْ لَا يَمَسُّهُمُ السُّوءُ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. And Allah will save those, will deliver those muttaqeen, will deliver those people who were aware of Him, who were in awe of Him. He will deliver them by that attainment. No evil will touch them. وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. لَا يَمَسُّهُمُ السُّوءُ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. They will not be touched by any harm, nor will they grieve. No evil will touch them, nor will they grieve. Remember these words. لَا يَمَسُّهُمُ السُّوءُ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. So they're not going to be touched by harm, nor will they grieve. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then mentions Allahu khaliqu kulli shay' wa huwa ala kulli shay'in wakeel, that Allah is the creator over all things and He is over all things the disposer of affairs. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes on to mention His power, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the people now being taken into their different places. وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا إِلَى جَهَنَّمَ زُمَرًا حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوهَا فُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا وَقَالَ لَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا أَلَمْ يَأْتِكُمْ رُسُلٌ مِّنْكُمْ يَتْلُونَ عَلَيْكُمْ آيَاتِ رَبِّكُمْ وَيُنذِرُونَكُمْ لِقَاءَ يَوْمِكُمْ هَذَا قَالُوا بَلَى وَلَكِنْ حَقَّتْ كَلِمَةُ الْعَذَابِ عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions now those people, those who rejected, being driven to hellfire in groups until they reach it and its gates are suddenly opened. And its keepers will say to them, did there not come to you messengers from amongst yourselves, reciting to you the verses of your Lord and warning you of this meeting? Of this meeting of yours, that this day would come. So they would say, yes, but the word of punishment has come into effect upon those who rejected. So this is now for those that continue to turn away, that you were warned, people told you, you know, that this would come, that there was a hereafter, messengers came to you and you were told that you would meet your Lord, you were told that you would meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So why did you wait? Why did you procrastinate? And they would say, they would acknowledge that yes, this happened, yes, we were warned, but at the same time, at this point now, the word of punishment has come into effect upon us. So there's nothing we can do at this point. قِيلَ ادْخُلُوا أَبْوَابَ جَهَنَّمَ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا فَبِئْسَ مَثْوَى الْمُتَكَبِّرِينَ. So they would be told to enter into the gates of hell, to abide therein, and wretched is the residence of the arrogant and of the prideful. Then Allah says, وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ زُمَرًا. But those who feared their Lord would be driven to paradise in these huge groups. حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوهَا وَفُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا وَقَالَ لَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ طِبْتُمْ فَدْخُلُوهَا خَالِدِينَ. That when they reached to paradise, وَفُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا, and the gates of paradise slowly open, unraveling itself. You know, hellfire is sudden when a person gets there. They're just thrown into hellfire. But paradise slowly, the gates open and you're seeing, you're marveling at the scene of paradise as it's opening in front of you. وَقَالَ لَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا, and the angels are saying to you, سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ, peace be unto you, طِبْتُمْ, you have become purified now, فَدْخُلُوهَا خَالِدِينَ, go ahead and enter once, you know, for once and for all, go ahead and enter and you will abide therein forever. وَقَالُوا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي صَدَقَنَا وَعْدًا. Those believers then say, praise be to Allah who fulfilled to us His promise. So we knew that this was going to happen. We prepared ourselves. We weren't from amongst those who denied or mocked. We weren't from amongst those who procrastinated. Alhamdulillah, alladhi sadaqana wa'ada. All praises be to Allah who guaranteed us what He guaranteed us and fulfilled the promise that He gave to us. وَأَوْرَثَنَا الْأَرْضَ نَتَبَوَّأُ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ حَيْثُ نَشَاءُ. And He made us inherit this land so that we may settle in paradise wherever we will. فَنِعْمَ أَجْرُ الْعَامِلِينَ. And what an excellent reward that this is for those who work deeds of righteousness. وَتَرَى الْمَلَائِكَةَ حَافِينَ مِنْ حَوْلِ الْعَرْشِ يُسَبِّحُونَ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّهِمْ. And you see the angels surrounding the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from all different directions. يُسَبِّحُونَ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّهِمْ. They're constantly glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَقُضِيَ بَيْنَهُمْ بِالْحَقِّ وَقِيلَ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. And it will be judged between them in truth, and it will be said, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, all praise and thanks to the Lord of all the worlds. So here, it's the celebration, the believers, the angels, the glorification of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the fulfillment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's promise, right? It's all coming to fruition in Surah Az-Zumar. In Surah Ghafir, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which Ghafir, of course, is the one who's ever forgiving. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Ghafir. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of course, mentioned to us, do not despair from the mercy of Allah. Inna Allah yaghfiru dhunuba jami'a, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives all sins. Surah Ghafir sort of brings us back now to the promises of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and what the angels are doing now and how Allah is forgiving now. So Surah Az-Zumar gave us a perspective, a window into what it looks like, what it will look like in the future, inshallah ta'ala, when we enter into paradise and when we are surrounded by those angels and when we are receiving the miracles of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Surah Ghafir emphasizes the way that Allah and the angels operate now. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Hameem, Tanzeelul Kitabi, Min Allahil Azizil Adeem. This is the revelation of the book of Allah, from Allah, the exalted in might and the all-knowing. Ghafir al-Dhanb, the one who forgives sins. Waqabil al-Tawb, the one who accepts repentance. Shadeed al-Iqab, the Tawl. He is severe in punishment, yet he's the bestower of bounties. So subhanAllah, Allah puts, once again, his attribute of forgiveness and his attribute of accepting of repentance before the punishment that comes to some people. And he's the owner of abundance. He's the Tawl. He's the one who bestows his favors upon all of his creation. La ilaha illa huwa ilayhi al-masir. There is no God except for him, and to him is the final destination. And remember the angels that inshallah ta'ala will greet us when we enter into paradise, bi'idhnillah, and they will say to us, Salamun alaykum tibitum. They would say, peace be unto you, you've been purified, enter into paradise forever, and they glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alongside us. Here another mention of the angels. And by the way, the angels are mentioned in all three surahs in this juz and in the capacity of comforting the believers. So the angels in all three surahs, Surah Az-Zumar, Surah Ghafir, and Surah Fussilat, the angels are mentioned in the capacity of comforting the believers and seeking forgiveness for the believers. So here in verse 7, what happens now? So inshallah ta'ala, bi'idhnillah, we hope we'll be greeted by them in paradise. But now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الَّذِينَ يَحْمِلُونَ الْعَرْشَ وَمَنْ حَوْلَهُ يُسَبِّحُونَ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّهِمْ وَيُؤْمِنُونَ بِهِ. So the angels are already surrounding the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they're glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيَسْتَغْفِرُونَ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. And what are they doing? They're seeking forgiveness for us. The angels right now are seeking forgiveness for us. They're not waiting for us to enter paradise to greet us and to say peace be unto you. They're already seeking forgiveness for us. And who made them seek forgiveness for us? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they're seeking forgiveness for those who believe. رَبَّنَا وَسِعْتَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ رَحْمَةً وَعِلْمًا فَاغْفِرْ لِلَّذِينَ تَابُوا وَاتَّبَعُوا سَبِيلَكَ وَقِهِمْ عَذَابَ الْجَحِيمِ. O our Lord, you have encompassed all things with your mercy and with your knowledge. فَاغْفِرْ لِلَّذِينَ تَابُوا وَاتَّبَعُوا سَبِيلَكَ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in Surah Az-Zumar, وَأَنِيبُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ. Then turn back to your Lord. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here says, the angels say, forgive those who have turned back to you. وَاتَّبَعُوا سَبِيلَكَ. And they followed your way. In Surah Az-Zumar, the second ayah in that equation was, وَأَسْلِمُوا لَهُ. Or the second word, it was, وَأَنِيبُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ. Turn back to your Lord. and submit yourself to him. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions وَاتَّبِعُوا أَحْسَنَ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ in Surah Az-Zumar. Turn back to your Lord, submit yourself to him, and follow the guidance that he sent to you. Here the angels are seeking forgiveness in Surah Ghafir. لِلَّذِينَ تَابُوا those who turned back, وَاتَّبَعُوا سَبِيلَكَ and those who followed your guidance. So it's complete correlation with Surah Az-Zumar, subhanAllah. وَقِيهِمْ عَذَابِ الْجَحِيمِ and protect them from the punishment of hellfire. In Surah Az-Zumar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَيُنَجِّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا بِمَفَازَتِهِمْ that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would save the believers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would save the believers from the punishment of hellfire. So here, the angels continue, رَبَّنَا وَأَدْخِلْهُمْ جَنَّاتِ عَدْنٍ الَّتِي وَعَدْتَهُمْ O Allah, and give them the paradise that you have promised to them. In Surah Az-Zumar, when the believers enter into paradise, they say, Alhamdulillah, الَّذِي صَدَقَنَا وَعْدًا All praises be to him who fulfilled his promise to us. So here the angels say, O Allah, enter them into the gardens of perpetual resonance, which you have promised them. وَمَنْ صَلَحَ مِنْ آبَائِهِمْ وَأَزْوَاجِهِمْ وَذُرِّيَاتِهِمْ And those who followed along from their fathers, from their spouses, from their offspring. إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ It is you who is exalted in might and all wise. وَقِهِمُ السَّيِّئَاتِ And O Allah, protect them from the evil consequences of their sins. In the very beginning of that equation in Surah Az-Zumar, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا Allah forgives all sins. So here, protect them from the evil consequences of their sins. And they continue to say, وَمَنْ تَقِ السَّيِّئَاتِ يَوْمَئِذٍ فَقَدْ رَحِمْتَ And he whom you protect from the evil consequences of their sins on that day, then you will have given him mercy. وَذَٰلِكَ هُوَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ And that is the supreme success. That's the great, attainment that you have promised to them. So subhanAllah, Surah Az-Zumar here and Surah Ghafir completely match. The angels are making dua for the very things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised us in Surah Az-Zumar. And then we move on to really this idea of da'wah, this idea of the person who's striving in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, doing their part and trying to warn the people and trying to call the people. First, we're bearers of glad tidings before we're warners, right? Calling the people to remember their hereafter, to remember that there is something that is greater than the world as we see it today. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions to us once again, because this is still Meccan Quran, the theme is the warning of punishment that came to the nations before, the glad tidings to those who believe, the comfort to the messengers, to the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to the followers of the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in verse 44 of Surah Ghafir, فَسَتَذْكُرُونَ مَا أَقُولُ لَكُمْ And you will remember what I am telling you. He's telling the Prophet ﷺ to say, and you will remember what I am telling you. You know, it will come to pass. Why is this being mentioned here? Because the Prophet ﷺ is constantly telling them, don't procrastinate, focus on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, seek forgiveness from him, he forgives everyone, he's most merciful, turn back to him. And the Prophet ﷺ is only being met with abuse and with insults. So, فَسَتَذْكُرُونَ مَا أَقُولُ لَكُمْ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the Prophet ﷺ to say to them, and you will remember what I am now saying to you, وَأُفَوِّضُ أَمْرِي إِلَى اللَّهِ And I have submitted my affair to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I've left my affair to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ اللَّهَ بَصِيرٌ بِالْعِبَادِ Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is seeing of his servants. He's all-seeing and all-observing of his servants. So the message here is that, you know, look, I've done my part. You will come to see this. We'll all come to see this. But I'm going to submit myself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And, you know, and I know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees my effort. I know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees what I'm doing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not let me down. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responds in verse 55. Fasbir, be patient. Inna wa'da Allahi haqq. Indeed, the promise of Allah is true. وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لِذَنْبِكَ وَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ بِالْعَشِيِّ وَالْإِبْكَارِ So be patient. Indeed, the promise of Allah is true. Seek forgiveness for your sins and exalt Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the praise of your Lord in the evenings and in the mornings. So this message is really focused to the da'iyah. It's focused to the one that calls to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? So in Surah Ghafir, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, be patient, particularly, not just the believers now, we've moved into another category. The believers who are calling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the believers who are engaged in working for His cause. Because they are the ones who are going to be insulted most, and they are the ones who are going to be challenged in their belief most, and they are the ones who are going to suffer and sacrifice the most. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, be patient, the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come to you, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you everything He has promised to you. Guess what the last surah in this juz does? Surah Fussilat, in which Fussilat literally means it's been explained. Subhanallah, what does Allah take us to? Verse 30. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا. That those who said, our Lord is Allah, and then they stayed firm upon that. تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. Once again, the angels. So subhanAllah, it's interesting because it's working backwards. Surah Az-Zumar is the angels when we enter Jannah. Surah Ghafir is the angels beneath the throne of Allah seeking forgiveness for us. And Surah Fussilat is the angels coming to us when we die. The angels now revealing themselves to us when we die. Verily, those who believed and they remain steadfast, تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ, the angels will come to them. And the Prophet ﷺ mentioned that the angels would land at the end of your sight, as far away as you can see. You would see the angels descend from paradise, and then they would have with them the kafan of from Jannah, from paradise, and the angel of death would come towards you, and they would say to you, أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الطَّيِّبَةُ, O pure soul, أُخْرُجِي إِلَى رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ وَرَضْوَانِ, come out to the mercy of Allah and to the pleasure of your Lord. Come on out. We were waiting for you, and now it's time. SubhanAllah, here, it's really powerful, because the angels are saying, they're descending at that time, and they're saying, fear not and grieve. أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا. Don't be afraid and do not grieve. Don't be afraid and do not grieve. Don't be afraid of what? Don't be afraid of that which came before. Okay, so don't be afraid of that which you're leaving behind you. And do not grieve over that which is coming after. So don't be afraid of that which you've left behind. And don't grieve for that which will come afterwards. You know? وَأَبَشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوَعَدُونَ. And receive the glad tidings of paradise which you were promised. نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاءُكُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. We were with you the entire time. We were your allies in this worldly life and in the hereafter. وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَشْتَهِي أَنفُسُكُمْ وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَدَّعُونَ نُزُلًا مِنْ غَفُورٍ رَحِيمٍ. You will have everything that you were promised, and you will have everything, and you will have access to everything that paradise has to offer. نُزُلًا مِنْ غَفُورٍ رَحِيمٍ. And this is a promise. This has come to you from the most forgiving, the most merciful. Surah Az-Zumar said, don't despair from the mercy of God, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is most forgiving and most merciful. Surah Ghafir is literally named after the most forgiving, and here, نُزُلًا مِنْ غَفُورٍ رَحِيمٍ وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا. And who is greater, مَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا, what is better than the one who calls to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and does good? So now it's comfort particularly to the da'i, to the one who's calling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who is better than the one who calls to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and does good deeds and works deeds of righteousness? وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. And he proudly declares that he is from the Muslims. وَلَا تَسْتَوِي الْحَسَنَةُ وَلَا السَّيِّئَةُ اِدْفَعْ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ. And evil is not equal to good. Respond to that which is evil with that which is good. Respond to that which is evil with that which is better. So we see, mashallah, we've got a lot of trolls today. We've got a lot of people that are saying, you know, some nasty things, who I will have to ban because they're being disrespectful. But always respond to that which is good with that which is evil with that which is better. Don't let people faze you. Remain steadfast on this path. Remain graceful. Remain a person who maintains a smile in the face of evil, who maintains grace in the face of nastiness. Repel that which is evil with that which is better. because they are not equal. So the idea here is to stay firm. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy will come to you, His forgiveness will come to you, and the angels will comfort you. So subhanAllah, connect these three surahs, Surah Az-Zumar, Surah Ghafir, Fussilat. Fussilat is literally as we leave this world, the angels coming and comforting those people who particularly remain firm on the path of da'wah. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us and have mercy upon us. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enter us into His gardens of perpetual residence. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to comfort us with the angels in this life and then in the next. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have mercy upon us and forgive us. And we ask Allah to guide our friends that have joined us today. The charity that I'm going to leave with you today, inshallah ta'ala, is one that's very close to my heart. ICNA Relief USA. For those of you that don't know, I actually was a part of Muslims for Humanity. ICNA Relief is literally Muslims for Humanity and Hurricane Katrina Relief. So I had the blessing of being the field coordinator and the outreach coordinator for Muslims for Humanity and Hurricane Katrina Relief. ICNA Relief does charity here at home. And the goal is to serve people here at home. And a lot of times we focus our charity efforts outside of the country, and our charity belongs first and foremost here at home. And so this is a charity that's near and dear to my heart. I've been a part of it. I'm proud to still be a part of it. And so inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to go ahead and post the link in the comments. So I hope that all of you will contribute to ICNA Relief inshallah ta'ala and consider this wonderful organization that continues to do so much work and naturally breaks many, many of the stereotypes that continue to follow us. So jazakumullah khairan to you all. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.